Yo, what is going on, everybody? It is your boy Underdog Fly, aka Clutch, aka 24/7. And as you guys can see here on the screen, we're 1-0 after destroying Sincere Huddle last game. The funny thing is, when that game froze, it did not save the score. And just to prove it, look at the score. It was not 38-7. It was 30-nothing. 30-nothing. And they put 38-7. But it was actually close, so I'm not gonna front on that. But we're gonna show y'all the standings for each division. As y'all can see, the Raiders are 2-0. The only reason is because G lost his game.
That's what I said.
Next, if the Steelers win, they should be on top of the division. I still have the Browns winning the division, which is actually hilarious. You see, everybody in the AFC South is 1-0. Bruh. And as you can see next, the Jets are the only team in the AFC East that won a game. Once again. Bruh. Like, here, in these divisions, I'm glad it's not real life. Because this really wouldn't happen in real life. The Saints is the only team to win in the NFC South. And the Giants isn't the only team to win in the NFC East. Because, and look, the Seahawks are the only team that won in their division. This is basically crazy. We have 6 teams that is undefeated in week 2. Well, still technically. But, no, we don't. As a matter of fact, it's still at least 16. I don't know what I'm thinking. But, we're actually going to get to week 2's game here. And we're going to play against the Eagles. And then, here's a little trade. Wait a second, Jared Allen is a punter? I am sleep. But this is a trade we're going to do. I'm going to trade Whitner and Elliot for Eric Weddle. Except. That's our big blockbuster trade right here. So, Elliot, good luck down there in Baltimore, bruh. But he's gone. So now, here's the big thing for me. Let's go ahead and running backs. Ezekiel Elliott is still on the team. I do not know why. But, as a matter of fact, I still get him for this week because this trade don't go until next week. Okay. So we still get Elliott for one game. This is actually really good. So we can just use him one last time. And the thing that I don't like is that I put experience on him. No, I did not. No, I didn't. Which actually is fine. But we also traded our star cornerback. I mean, not cornerback. It was strong safety, which is Dante Whitner. But Walter Thurman and James ahead. Why can I not say this man's last name? But them two is going to have to step it up. And I'm going to tell y'all this. Walter Thurman there, I believe he is the man for the job there, even though Whitner can still do a lot. But I'm going to tell y'all this. Elliot going to Baltimore. I don't know if they're going to. I don't know what he's going to do down there in Baltimore. But hopefully that does really help. Because Forsett, I still think he's the answer. But maybe he'll run a 2 running back set. Which will actually be pretty smart. But I don't know. So we're going to go and play our game against the Eagles. We're trying to go 2-0. We're trying to go perfect. But let's see what we can do. And here with us right now, as a matter of fact, is the man who owns the Baltimore Ravens, Dreamer G 2014. What's going on, man?
Nothing much.
So what are you going to do with Elliot, just to stop all this little thoughts about it?
Spy mission for a 9-inch track.
I'm going to use him for my option game.
But I mean, like, don't you want to
Since I'm running the option a lot more, I'm going to use him for the option.
Let me go to ask you a really good question.
I'm going to
Did you put your freaking voice in the freaking chat?
Yes, I did.
Did you go and recheck it?
I can get this in time.
I just put it in like right when you was announcing me. I put it in.
All right. I was about to say, because a whole bunch of people has been screwing me over for that. And I don't not want to be like I'm talking to myself looking all crazy. But we're going to let you go ahead and watch the stream, which is like a little bit. Yo, Carson Wentz is already 16 for 28, 218 yards, a touchdown, and interception. It's pretty crazy. And look at Romo up there, 10 for 15, 107 yards, and two touchdowns. I forgot to show y'all who is the weekly awards. I forgot to show y'all that, but I'll show y'all that at the end of this video. And if you would like G to stick around and to go ahead and commentate on the game, if you can see it, and if you would like. But let's go ahead and get this week two started. Alright. They really ain't giving Beasley love back here. So this is the last game for Elliot, and this is the last game for Whitner. So they better step it up. And one thing for the Cowboys, if Romo goes down, I don't know what we're going to do, to be very honest. We have Fitzpatrick as backup, but we need something better than that. Uh-oh, they blitzing out here already. And still catching the ball, Mr. Dez. Come on now. They coming out here with the heat, yo. Yo, this is the week that Romo got injured in real life, so we really are trying to avoid that right now. Going to send him over. Let's see what we can do. Second down and three. Good stuff. Oh, come on, Elliot. You need to get out there, boy. Now, this is the question that I want y'all to say in the chat. Oh, it's 31. In the comments, as a matter of fact. After Elliot leaves this team, how do y'all think? Coon was about to be gone. But for real. How do y'all think Elliot would do in Baltimore? Because I believe that is a big blockbuster trade. I don't think it is like real big, but I still think it's an impactful trade. Oh, let's go. Hey, oh, no face mask on that? Because I really believe that Baltimore already has Forsett. Y'all have another running back, I believe, unless you released them. But other than that, Baltimore should be fine in a running game. But that trade, I don't know if that was good for the ooze. Yeah. All right, Elliot. Elliot, you need to get out there, bro. You need to do something. Well, I don't know. We'll see how it is. Let's see how it benefits both teams. Come on. There you go, Colston. Good dot by Romo. Romo 4-for-4 right now. Doing pretty good. And just to let y'all know, this is on all Madden mode. So I'm pretty afraid of throwing the ball, to be very honest. Because the play recognition and ball hawking on defense is just crazy. Look at that. See? That was a terrible throw. I threw it a little bit too late. As a matter of fact, I should have lopped that. But let's go ahead and try a screen one more time. And he makes a beautiful hit. If I can't hit Elliot, I'm going to hit Whitten. Oh, now we're hitting him. Go, boy. Oh, look at Elliot, baby. Go, Elliot. Touchdown, Cowboys. Let's go. Elliot trying to ball out on his last game with the Cowboys. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get it. For that offense, that was a really, now, really this is the tough thing that I need to worry about. The defense. Huff's got it on the return. Now, Carson Wentz. Already seen he has one touchdown on the year, one interception already on the year. Yeah, actually, it looks like he was balling out because the team is 1-0. 218 yards. He was over half on his completions. Let's see what we can do here on defense. Hopefully, we can get the user game on fleek. Let's just see what we can do. Oh, they running the ball. Oh, no. This is what I was talking about. Oh, my. That's what exactly I was talking about, because they'll do some crazy stuff for no reason. All right. Oh, whew. Almost broke the controller. Oh, they still running the ball. Oh, no. Ooh, good stuff. Almost dropped the controller. Well, yo, they really running the ball on this defense right now. So we're going to have to try and stop that. Carson Wentz, they probably told him, don't even throw the ball, man. Just hand it to Sproles. That's probably how they won the game, though. And as you see, our brand new pickup, Robert Kemdichi. Hit him! Ah. So I forgot to tell y'all that we got Kemdichi, and we have somebody else who I forgot that we also picked up. I need to figure out who was that. I forgot who that was. Well, they running the ball again. There we go. Yo, so I don't know how many yardage. Let's see. I don't know how much yardage they have, but I want to check the running back stats for the full year. Let's see what they wide open. Scandrick once again. Oh, and another person that we went and picked up was my man. Let's go ahead and scroll over to him. A key to lead. I thought that would be a huge upgrade to the defense. Come on, Kim D. There you go, Whitney. A key to lead, Robin Kim Ditchie. And now, next week, bringing in Eric Weddle. Oh, that's going to be crazy, bro. Y'all don't even understand how good that is. There you go. Yo, they really running the ball on us, bro. They really said after Sam Bradford ain't even with us, he said we just going to run the ball. Golly. Now let's go, man. I'll use him. Let's go. Good defense. Yo, Carson Wentz ain't doing anything. Let's go ahead and keep that in check. And I'm glad that we can hold them to three here and that it did not go over 2-minute warning because we did not want to hurry up. Oh, he almost got it, bro. I should have switched on and tried to dive for it. Let's go. Let's see if we can get something here on the kick return. Oh, maybe. Let's see if we can cut over to the left. Cut. Ah, we need a good kick return. I'm going to see if we can have Devin Hester, if someone hasn't picked him up already. Or someone. But in this game, I kind of want to run down the clock. Let's go. He threw him right at him. That's fine. He almost got 600 yards on the year almost. He hits at 185. No, he's not. 120 something. Doing pretty all right now. Oh, who's the what? What are you doing, man? We're going to go fullback dive because Coon, my man. Nah, we're not going to. We're going to do that, and then we're going to have Whitten come out like that. Oh, go for it. There you go. Oh, that hurts. Ooh, that hurts. But it's the Dallas Cowboys. We going for it, man. Let's do it. I do want to hit Johnson out there. Let's see if we can hit him. Uh-oh. Ah, they blitzed me. Ah, that was a good play by the D. Good play by defense. I kind of, as soon as I saw that, I was like, man, that's probably what won't work. Good defense, bruh. There you go, Curry. You got your sack. Let's go. Go ahead, bring him up. If they run the ball on me like they have been doing, it's going to be a different game. It really is. Boom. Talib, what are you doing, bro? Let's go ahead and use one QB contain. see what we can do here. I might blitz him on this one because they might run it off. Oh, they don't. Oh, man. Good play. Good play. I'll give you all that. Good play. That was pretty good. But we get ball back. I kind of played it a little too safe on that offensive drive, trying to run down the clock. But we'll see what we can do on the next one. Come on. Oh, oh. We cannot injure this wide receiver, though. Because Beasley is low-key.
What the fuck? Key player. It says Peyton Manning is an 84 overall quarterback. Why didn't I just put him as my starting quarterback?
Because you can't change the play since you put him in there. Because he's a punter.
No, I know, but he's at the right now he's third string, and it says he's an 84 overall quarterback. I'm about to put him as my starter.
But he ain't going to make them catch throws that he usually do.
And he'll make some.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Oh, another blitz, another blitz. That's Brian wide let's open, baby. Go, Brian. Let's go, Brian. I want you to throw up that X for me one time. Oh, no. Throw up that.
Peyton Manning.
Let's accuracy. Go. That's Brian. Deep throw up that X, boy.
Don't run.
Let's go.
Play action. Peyton
Manning. I miss football.
Where next, Peyton
Manning? I miss football right now, bro. Oh man, beautiful job by Dez Bryant on that one. And I saw that blitz coming. I said, let me dump it off to him real quick. Dez Bryant one time, bro. Sproles, I dare you bring it out. Don't. Okay. All right. So now we get ball back at half. Really great touchdown right here. They have one timeout. I'm going to use our Curry. First down at the 20. Not anymore. Ooh, look at. What? What? Bruh, I feel bad for this Carson Wentz, though. Like, just imagine the person who has to use our Carson Wentz. Like, he can't. Boom. Ah. He can't. I'm not going to say he can't throw the ball. He can throw the ball, but he's not accurate at all. Or, all right, that's going to be halftime. But, bro, I don't understand. This Carson Wentz is like a 80-something overall. I don't know what the person who made this roster was thinking, putting him at that low of an overall. But I'm going to tell y'all something. We're not trying to lose. Like, I'm going to show y'all my talent by putting this on All Madden. Not at All Pro. All Pro is too easy. Like, I can go 16-0 easy on All Madden. Look at the stats here. They're killing us on the run game. But I'm going to tell y'all this. Elliot and... what you call it? Elliot and Dez Bryant coming up with the clutch TDs right here. We're going to keep this game going. And we will definitely miss Ezekiel Elliott right after this game because his speed, he's the fastest running back that we have on our team. But we are bringing in more help on the defense. This game, I do not want to play Alfred Morris. But I'm going to say this. Even though the trade has already been accepted, do anybody know, can you still trade Elliott if he gets hurt? Because if I send him an injured player when the trade has already been accepted, and he has to accept the fact that he's out for the year, did EA let that happen?
Oh, fuck no.
That would be really messed up. That really would be. And if they do, I'm going to laugh hysterically.
He's injured?
No. I was just thinking, what if I do get him injured for the year and then I already accepted the trade with you? Will they cancel the trade or will they just give it to you?
They better fucking cancel the fucking trade.
I don't know what they would do if they if that would happen. I don't know if any of that happened before. But If I was EA, I would make that happen, though. If you already accepted it, then played your game and injured him, yeah, you should have an injury prior. Because that's your fault for accepting the trade. But if it was me, let me finish. If it was me who actually accepted a trade and I'm getting an injured product, I shouldn't. I should just stay with him because I accepted it. That don't even sound right. It really don't. I'll say that it is your fault for saying you accepted it because I'm starting him in this game because this is the last. Oh my, Darren Sproles is killing us right now. 71 rush. I wanted to be the best running defense in the league, but apparently you can't keep Darren Sproles contained for long. I wish you could, but you just can't. I'm gonna see if I can do this. Uh-oh. Oh, get through, baby. Ah, I told y'all that awareness with the QBs and everybody is just there. Like, if that was us, that would have been an extra 2 seconds that we had to get that ball out there, though. But, yeah, that's kind of the discussion I want to talk about. If somebody gets injured and you already accepted the trade, should you still get the... I'm sleep. That better be false start. Thank you. If you already traded, got a trade, and somebody injured him, and then the next week comes in, do you still get the person or not? Is that a little glitch? Or is it just straight up, you just can't do that? I'm going to see.
I don't even think they allow somebody to get hurt.
Oh, that was almost an interception. Oh, that would have been sick. This is a funny thing, though. They're doing a lot of running on my defense, and they're doing a lot of screens for some reason. Not a lot of them, but okay, Skandrick. Yeah, I need a new cornerback for real. Like, Skandrick always leaving people open man-to-man coverage, and he always getting mossed on. Like, we might need to. I'll go ahead and put him on a trade block and see what we can get for him. 1, 2, 3, 4. We send a nanos on the. We send a nanos on him. What in the world is? Who is that? They sending screens on my defense. Like, what is this about? It's crazy. If we end up losing this game, I'm not going to say that it's because of EA. I'm going to say it's because of the run game. This run game is kind of killing us a little bit. Uh-oh. Who do I use it?
Did they score on y'all?
Yeah, they scored on us. Oh, see? And they using the stupid comeback route, too. Like, low-key, the Eagles are using low-key money plays on us. Easy for the players to manage, and what we got there is a throw and a catch, and now they have a pretty good chance of getting the first down. Third down and two. Ah, see? They using money plays on us, bro. They went and used a motion, and they kicked it out to the running back, yo. This ain't funny, yo. It really isn't. And why is the car still running when I hit him out of bounds? Ask me that question. Put him right here. There you go. Good D. Good D. Alright. Let's go into this fourth quarter. We are 14-10. Let's go ahead and stop Sproles. And let's not get cheesed by EA on this one. Let's really not. These offenses have been held in check all day long.
What might be the mindset right now going into the last quarter? Yo, the player's on trade block.
Oh, come on, Lee. Put that A tackle on him and you ain't do anything?
I traded 2 6-round draft picks for Julius Peppers.
Let's use Crawford.
Who else is in here that I can get?
Let's go, good defense. Let's go, McLean. See you out here, boy. Are they going for two or are they going for field goal? They are going for two. Ooh. Okay. All right, let's do this. If they run the ball, I'm screwed. Good. Let's go. Good defense, bruh. Let's go. We're in the fourth quarter, and now all right. We have to hope the defense. So now I'm not going to play too conservative, because last time we played conservative, we allowed a touchdown. You're coming down.
It's my right.
All
right.
Oh, one-handed catch by Jason Witten. Now.
Let's go.
Oh. I kind of panicked and saw him coming at me, and I pushed Y and X at the same time. I'm glad that they allowed me to go to Witten on that play. Established a run, 20 rushing yards to gain XP. Do I really want to gain XP for him when he's going to the Ravens? Oh, good spin. Oh, my. Who was that? Connor Baldwin coming at me like that? What? Okay. Dez Bryant, let's hit you out here. They better hurry to get the snap. Oh no. Oh my gosh, that was almost an interception. Ooh, let's calm down. Let's calm down. Let's go screen on this one. I don't know why I'm gonna be screen. But if we can't get anything with Morris, we'll hit Witten. There you go. Bro, Morris, why are you so slow? What in the world? We're going to go for it. For one reason only. Just to get this first down. Come on. Come on. Let's go! Jason Witten is clutch, bro. Look at that throw by Romo under pressure. Bro, we won this game. All we got to do is just keep that ball. Look at this. Romo under pressure. Beautiful catch by Witten. Bruh. How can you not hate Romo for that? Come on now. Plus, we gutsy for this. We're undefeated on fourth downs. That might be not true. Nah, that's probably not true because the game accelerated. And we probably didn't do anything on fourth down. Run, 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 run. There we go, Elliot. That's what I like to see. There we go. Smelling like some rotisserie chicken. 15 rushing yards finally. If we can get like 7 more yards, we should be fine. Can't do anything when the offensive line don't want to hold anyone. Alright, we're going to go power row. We want Witten to come. No, we want Witten to come out this way. There we go. Interception. I didn't rip. Horrible throw. Horrible decision on my part. That's why you don't gamble. You should just run the ball. But nah, I wanted to go for it. That's my fault. Boom. Is he still in bounds? Yes, he's still in bounds. Wow. Let me use bounds on this side. That's out. He's out.
Phil, it's third down. They are in four down territory, and the defense knows that.
All right, third and inches.
In a situation like this, Jim, on the defensive side, you need one of your pass rushers to come through and get on that quarterback.
The Eagles have it at the 34. And he reaches out and makes the catch. One hand.
Wow. Randall really catching that over now a key to lead. Really
crucial the rest of the way.
And there's a touchdown. I'm sleep. How, bro? I'm sleep.
We have a late lead change on that touchdown I'm pass in the red zone. But this
well, we
game
down by a still goal because that's all we need.
Remaining with plenty of time to go.
It's been a crazy day, no doubt about it.
Field goal. This is why I don't usually like to play it safe. I usually do it against the computer because computer usually don't what you call it react to it. This is on that. They react to everything. I should have known better. Not in hindsight. Go Beasley.
Beasley's running this one out. And they have this return.
If he would have fumbled, I think I just covered. Disbanded the whole league. All right. Let's go. That's Bryant. I might throw it up to you. I do not want you to drop this ball.
Big time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very conservative.
We might just lose this game.
So make sure you have play call to take advantage of the fact that they're going to be very conservative on the defensive side.
The Cowboys have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth.
Brian, one-on-one over there.
Second down and 10.
Good catch, Witten.
Witten's got the catch and the first. The Cowboys signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. First
pretty
down.
Clutch, but we need pressure on every step. And we're going to have Elliot out there.
Set at the line. Dime package. First down at the 20.
Run outside, run outside, run outside.
He's going to scramble. Feeling the heat.
Wow.
Bailey's
we only need to get to the 39.
The sidelines. They know they need to get
I tried to go
to
real deep.
To give him any chance at all. Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
There you go, Witten.
Witten.
Let's hurry up.
That's his fourth catch of the day.
Hurry up.
Now on first down.
Dang.
Every snap crucial the rest of the way. Romo set in the pistol. First down at the 42.
Once again.
The Cowboys
there you go,
Witten. Move the chain.
Call him some timeout.
No surprise. They
now, if we can't get anything in the air,
the Cowboys
we're
going to
go
one
and run it one more time.
First down and 10. Romo's on the move.
Oh, this is.
What
Let's go.
First down.
Oh, that was clutch.
Now.
Oh, that was clutch.
After the
I might
long
need to call
game, let's see what they do here. Hand off by Romo.
There you go, Elliot.
The Cowboys have to call one right here, and they do.
Now,
and they are out of
they are
outs.
Telling
the offense heads to the
to
line
go
for the seventh play of the drive.
Ford Phil.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Romo standing back
got
in
something.
The shotgun ready for
we
the
got
snap.
Something.
Ducks out of bounds.
Can't do it. If I can't find anything,
must convert scenario. Third down coming up here in the late stages. Yes, that's four down territory, but you don't want to face make or break at this point.
Yeah, on the defensive side, now it's time for the coach to do his job. Be aggressive.
We're gonna just go for the field goal.
That the offense has not seen so far today.
Do it.
If you
do, it kind of got me nervous on that one.
So the offense
good job,
does
Romo.
Good work. To drive down the field, get in position, and
if
kick
they
the
return
field
this for
goal
a touchdown,
to tie this
I'm
game in the late stages.
Yeah, really you know what's going to be fun.
Oh, we got
huffed out is which team is willing to take a chance.
Boom!
Will the offense be aggressive? Will the defense
now
take some chances? The
this is where it gets interesting.
I think that's the one that's going to win the game.
They look
the
like
Cowboys defense
they're not
comes
going
onto the
to
field. A tie game in the late going, trying to make sure they do not allow the winning points.
Yeah, you're right. That's what they're
I'm
thinking.
I'm gonna have
to. And I tell you, the big thing is to make sure.
And now if they catch this,
up,
oh, they just run
the
ball.
Extend your arms.
Okay.
And wrap up the ball carrier.
Now, this is my worst
receiver.
Enemy.
Don't give up the big play. We're trying to get this game into
point.
Time has run out in regulation. And
I never
yes, indeed, we are going to
if
overtime.
If I ever win a coin toss, I get really excited.
You're in overtime.
Let's see. We're going to choose tails. Let's go! Okay, we got a coin toss. All right, let's get it. Now, we better not screw this up. We better not screw this up. This is the first time I got a coin toss in a while. First thing that came to mind, tails never fails.
Yeah.
And then heads is a dread. I don't know why I chose tails in that situation, though. But kind of glad I did.
Rules change if you receive the
now,
ball first and get a touchdown.
Application for what?
Over. However, if you take the ball down on your first drive and only manage a field goal, the other team will have a chance to tie or win the
don't
game. And if both teams get
so
field
gonna
goals
do what we
on
need
their
to
open
do.
Drives, the next team to score from there will win
the game.
We're gonna
run
the
ball actually.
The Cowboys stepping back onto the field to get this next
now,
drive underway.
I do not mind us going all the way down to getting the top.
A field goal.
Now when I think
yeah,
of
I think they feel good about that field goal. They made some good plays and they got
there. You go.
There,
don't fumble.
That's
all we asking you to do. Don't
in position
fumble.
Where they can kick the field goal. Now you take the knowledge that you gained from that last
don't
drive,
fumble.
Use it and try to go down there now.
Fumble.
Score a touchdown.
They're
they got to be wondering though, can they finish off a drive today? Trying to beat the play clock. Complete. What a hit that time.
Yes, Brian. What are you doing?
Time,
let's go through
the
money play.
Just
us.
As the
oh, but we got Morris on third
and
down.
Makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Third down and four. Morris with the grab. This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the
distance. Good job, Morris.
It's third down, Jim. You expect the team to throw the football down the field past the chains to get the first down. No, they catch them off guard. They throw a screen pass. Nice execution.
But you know, my boy Elliot out here trying to get another touchdown.
Second and four following the run.
Oh, shoot.
Tony Romo will take it right from the center.
I don't want to do that. Juan Chandler, can you block for me?
Second down, four to go.
Well.
Back to him. Cowboys offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play.
Now.
But what happens to run, loose?
I do not mind a tie.
That's just a bad
like
job
I said.
The offensive line. Loss of three on the play.
If we can get Morris out here or.
Now loading up, expecting pass.
There it is.
With a dime.
Good catch, Witten. Oh, he's still up.
And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Steady drive.
So far.
Just what I wanted to do in the first place.
The tight end makes the catch.
Nothing too much.
You got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember,
we're going to hit Witten.
The closest receiver
one more time.
To the quarterback.
We can. Nah, we're going to hit Escobar. And there we go. We got that first down, and we in field goal range. Now I'm take off accelerate clock.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field.
Got a minute left.
We saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
We're gonna bring him up.
First and 10.
Uh-oh. Oh no.
Tony Romo's pass was intended for Jason Witten. I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player.
Wow.
He's in position.
I almost screwed it up
able
again.
To, make the football
I almost did it again.
The Cowboys from the 32. Screen.
Go.
The completion.
Go, Elliot. Go, Elliot.
The hit.
Bruh, Elliot is a beast.
The tackle.
Elliot is a beast. I cannot believe I just traded Elliot.
Coaches
I really cannot.
Love it when there's a pass.
But y'all probably saying,
you're crazy. That
ball, why are you
trading? They can break a tackle. That's just some extra yards. And that's what you're looking for. And that's what it takes to be a winning football team.
All right, let's hurry up. Hurry up. I'm
going
to try
drive.
To get one more playoff. Watch, I screw it up again.
Quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Williams.
Hold on as this goes incomplete.
Oh,
Williams is not able
my.
To come up and get
Terrence Williams, you're some trash. You are some trash.
They take their eyes off
come on, Morris.
Or they're just trying to get it in their hands too quick.
I'm sweet.
Now,
let's just get out with field goal and let's get out of here. 5, 4, 3, 2.
The Cowboys
timeout.
Face fourth down, but want to take a time.
Let's get out of here.
With that W.
And the kick
go.
Is good for three. This one had to
MVP of the game.
A little overtime.
I kind of want to say it's Witten.
Well, I guess the phrase that stinking
but
kicker choke.
I'm gonna say the MVP of this game is Tony Romo. One because it was
right
some
moment.
Clutch catches at the end. I'm not gonna put anything on him for the interceptions because that's my fault. He's not controlling himself. I am. Another thing is Elliot had a great game on his
so
game out.
Sims and
we actually bucked
Sports.
Up
Jim
and
so long for now.
We got passing. We had the passing game unlocked. The running game, we definitely need to work on that. Who should our starter be? Should it be Alfred Morris or should it be Dunbar? Should we give Dunbar a little bit of chance? Because one thing is Alfred Morris is slow. He is just really, really slow. And I couldn't deal with it anymore. I almost couldn't take it. Carson Wentz going 12 for 18, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions. Actually having a really good game. Romo go for 18 to 28, 317 yards, 2 touchdowns and an interception. Actually really good. Darren Sproles actually having a really good game with 80 yards. Elliott had 26 in his game out. And I wish he would have had a touchdown rushing, but I mean catching it, it was actually really. He was actually much better than everything else. Receiving, he actually had a really good day in receiving. But Jason Witten, he saved us. He really did. Reuben Randle catching it over, I think it was a key to lead. Was that a key to leave? I don't. Let me see the highlights. Like, what quarter was it? Fourth. Yeah. Wait, it was 18-yard touchdown. Where are we at? No, not there. Yeah, Randall for 16 yards. There it is. Watch this. Oh, wait. Let's see who's out here first. It was Randall on the key to leave. Steve. How do you see how close Really, bruh? You just let that happen to you? Bruh, I'm done. Well, that's going to be the end of the gameplay. Thumbnail is actually being done right now. But week three, we got to go up against the Beast. We almost lost to a division rival. Getting that clutch win right there, that was pretty good. That was really good. Now, everybody, we salute to our man Ezekiel Elliott, who went up 84 overall now for our team. I don't know if it goes to his team as an 84 overall, but he's probably happy that I didn't injure him on purpose. Now, one more thing. What was we checking? Yeah. We was checking the weekly awards. We're on the stats. That's right. So week one, it went to Matthew Stafford and Jason Hatcher. 5 tackles, 3 sacks. Man, he had a game. And on AFC, we got D'Angelo Williams, 15 carries, 103 yards, 4 rushing touchdowns, and 1 reception. Really, bruh? Y'all really just let him do that? Who the Steelers play with? The Patriots. I just realized they did that to the Patriots. Yo, so y'all need to see them stats one more time. Tony Romo is first in the league in passing yards, touchdowns, and third in passer rating. If he's healthy, we all know that's what's going to be happening in real life, to be honest with you. And week three. Let's get into the week three games. Let me go ahead back and put the song back on.
I'm at the next life support.
And then that's... Let's go ahead and get this going so we can roll on out of here.
Wait, it hasn't even came yet.
All right. So here... For our week three matchup, y'all know that I have a user game against the Beast with the Falcons, which y'all can see right here. Other important games is Sincere Huddle going up against the Redskins. Let's see, who does he play this week? He has to play the Beast this week. That's going to be a kind of rough game. The thing is with Sincere, I 30-0 him, and with the Beast, I actually had trouble with him. Only reason why I had trouble with him, because his defense was actually great at most points, to the point where I almost went 4 and out on him. We was playing draft champions, actually. But with these teams, I honestly will say that he will abuse me with Julio Jones this week. So that's why I'm trying to, like, keep myself together, try to get this team right, try to figure out who our running back is for this next game. And we need to see what we need to do to keep this game in check. Next, the Ravens got to go up against the Bengals. After losing a tough game to the Raiders, it's going to be hard. And that's basically it with the games other than the Seahawks. We'll see y'all next time. Peace.